Так, ребята, еще раз. Я веду репортаж из американского съезда ковбоев, владельцев оружия. И мы хотим сейчас взять интервью некоторых людей. Hello, sir, how are you doing?
Good, good.
You don't mind to give a few words to Russian people who love cowboys and who love Texas?
Love the Texas, huh?
Yes. Russian patriots, they stay with Texan.
Okay, well, go Trump.
Absolutely. I already told people we need to help Trump. They said that Russian collusion, right?
Yeah.
They said Russian collusion. They said that Trump was the one. Putin helped Trump to become a president, so I told the Russian people we need to help him again. What do you think about that?
Yes, we need to help Trump again.
Absolutely. What do you think about Biden sending lots of money and guns to Ukraine? How you feel about it?
I don't.
You don't? You don't like it, or you don't feel anything about it?
I don't like it.
He doesn't like it.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Russian people stand with Texas, and Russian people stand with President Trump. Right. Thank you for your input. Ну, в общем, он сказал, что ему совершенно не нравится то, что помогают, Байден посылает деньги на Украину, и он просит русских голосовать за Трампа, помочь с Трампом. Я говорю, конечно, мы поможем. Вот это сидит пресса американская. Я буду не удивлюсь, если здесь половина из этой прессы будут либералы, которые просто тупо... которые тупо голосуют за либералов, они ненавидят Трампа. И я не знаю точно, с каких средств массовой информации они. Брайан Армстронг. Один не знал, вот это. Но они на меня косятся, потому что я хожу в российской футболке. Сейчас найдем какого-нибудь такого, знаете, зажигательного ковбоя. Какого-нибудь такого яркого. И там возьмем тоже интервью у этих ковбоев. Вот мы у одного уже спросили. Вот. Они все говорят, что да. Я говорю, а Путин помог Трампу выбраться первый раз. Вы хотите, чтобы Путин снова помог Трампу выбраться? Он говорит, да, да. Я говорю, согласен, пусть русские помогут Трампу выбраться. Вот. А против посылки денег Украине. Can I ask you? Hello, sir. Can I ask you a couple questions for Russian patriots? Can I ask you a couple questions for Russian patriots?
Not understanding.
Can I ask you a couple questions?
I probably don't know the answers. I'm kind of dumb.
I don't think so. How do you feel about President Biden sending guns and money to Ukraine? Do you support it or not?
It's moronic not to.
So you want them to send money to Ukraine?
Well, if we cannot defend democracy, what's the use?
So you think there's democracy in Ukraine?
I'm saying, you know, the only way you can find out is to let the current government function.
Uh-huh.
And when they're at war, they can't function.
You know that Ukrainian president ordered to destroy all the Christian Orthodox Church. How you feel about that?
Which church?
Christian Orthodox Church, he destroyed all the churches in Ukraine.
Well, you know, you can only take one step at a time. You got to get free before you can free anything up.
So you think...
And if you do not stop Putin, they won't have any church if Putin...
So Putin built few churches, very large churches. Basically, he just built brand new ones.
That's good, but
yes,
he doesn't make anybody
so how you feel democracy is really one to destroy religion? What about freedom of religion? Isn't it part of democracy?
No.
No. It's so there is no democracy.
It's something democracy will grant.
So there is no democracy in Ukraine because there's no freedom of church.
I'm not in Ukraine. I cannot tell you whether what their current laws are. I have trouble keeping up with the U.S.
Right,
laws,
right.
not foreign laws.
But you find with people, our veterans sleeping on the streets and sending billions of dollars to Ukraine.
Well, when Putin sends over 300,000 bombs or so, and destroys all their cities. They got no place else to sleep.
Yes, Americans are destroying Iraq, Libya, Syria, Belgrade.
Now,
so this was fine, right?
Which one are you going to talk about? talk about one subject democracy, at a time. Let's don't try to confuse or equate everything mm-hmm. as equal, because everything's not equal. Mm-hmm.
So Putin fighting in Ukraine is evil, but America fighting all over the world is okay.
No, Putin invading a free country.
It's our country. It's Russian. Not. Ukraine is Russia.
No, it isn't.
It's Russia. It's been Russia forever. All right, so I got you. I got your idea. Yeah, I got you. Вы поняли? А короче, Путин кошмарный идиот, который тиран, который попал, значит, пошел в другую страну, Украину. Я говорю, Украина — это наша страна. Он говорит, нет, это не ваша страна. Я говорю, хорошо. А что тогда делала Америка в Сирии, в Белгороде, в Ираке и в других странах? И он говорит, это нормально, никаких проблем. Дайте попробуем тут спросить. Hello guys, just can you, don't you mind to answer one question for Russian patriots who voted for Trump? Because the Russian collusion, they said Russian Putin helped to President Trump to win in the first election. So, do you want Russia to help President Trump to win again? Because we're ready to help. Do you want me to repeat the question, or did you hear what I said? Okay, how do you feel about Biden sending tons of money and guns to Biden, to Ukraine?
How do you
think Biden sending money to Ukraine, how you feel about it? And guns. Do you support the Biden administration sending tons of money to Ukraine? I mean, you support it or not? It's a simple question. Or you just don't know how to answer. Okay, so the pussy, they're afraid to say something, they're afraid to speak up, that's fine, we'll find somebody else. Короче, эти боятся рот открыть, они думают, что сейчас я их сниму. Знаете, вот вам свободная страна. Сидит три мужика взрослых, они просто-напросто побоялись вообще ответить на мой вопрос, если они поддерживают то, что Украину посылают деньги. Ну, давайте спросите, попробуем сейчас этих спросить. Hello, guys. Do you mind me to ask a question for Russian channel? It's an independent Russian channel. We want to know if you guys support President Trump or you support Biden sending money and guns to Ukraine. What's your
Definitely Trump. I wouldn't give Biden 2 cents.
So how you feel this in Russian collusion that Biden was saying that President Trump got elected because of Putin help him? Russians okay with that? We can help again. Do you want us to help elect Putin again second time?
Well, everything that comes out of, if Biden's lips are moving, mm-hmm. he's lying.
Right.
So, I'm sorry, I lost your question and all that.
How do you feel about Biden sending money to Ukraine? And do you want Russian to help elect President Trump again? Because they keep saying Russian collusion, Putin help elect President Trump first time. So Russian saying, we can help again, just ask us, we can do it again.
It's BS, I won't say the word. BS, because if anybody's in with Ukraine, it's the Bidens.
Right.
But Ukraine does need help. But there was no Russian collusion.
Yes.
Anybody would have.
So nobody believes it, right?
No.
Because Russians already laughed and they said, okay, so we can now elect President of United States. So let's just go to election and elect President of United States again. If it's a Russian collusion and it depends on Russia, we can go ahead and vote for Trump again.
Well, everybody should vote for Trump again, but that there is no Russia collusion,
right.
And there will not be.
Right.
Not with Trump.
Totally. I'm sure when people, how many supporters came who lost President Trump, and people come here to support him, and we're going to vote Trump again. And they telling on the TV that Biden is very popular, the most popular president in the world. So I want to show Russian people that's a bit baloney.
No, Russian people don't believe it. Biden has been a crook for 50 years in government.
Right.
That hasn't changed. And he's starting to...
Dementia, right.
But his whole career has been one big crime.
Agreed.
So do not believe anything he says, Russia.
Thank you so much for your opinion. And you, sir, do you support the Biden administration send tons of money and weapons to Ukraine to corrupt Zelensky, who is destroying Christian churches, and he is buying mansions in Florida one after another?
I'm sorry, what now?
Do you support President Biden sending money to Ukraine to corrupt Zelensky, who is destroying Christian churches and buying mansions in Florida?
Not really. I mean, like I say,
you don't have opinion.
Not so much on that. I mean, I think Ukraine's probably need some help, but I think it's just the fact that they're writing blank checks.
Don't America need some help as well, especially the veterans sleeping on the streets in the tents in California, San Francisco, veterans sleeping on the streets. Don't they need money? Why we need to send money to Ukraine and then Zelensky buying mansion and villas and yachts?
Yeah, I didn't realize he was doing that, but I think there's not enough control.
What's American business to help Ukraine? What's our business there?
Not sure that it is.
Well, you don't have opinion why we're helping Ukraine?
Not really. I mean, I don't follow it that much, really.
Right. Well, just to say it, you know how they saying, if you don't care about politics, politics come to you. Yeah. That's what's going to happen. Do you have opinion, sir?
My opinion, we shouldn't be sending Ukraine any money without accountability of where it's going and how it's being spent. It seems to me like just money ain't getting it. Arms are a little different. Money, no accountability, no money.
For the money-wise, have you heard that some money they already appeared in Africa, and some of our military equipment appeared in the Taliban and in other countries? So the equipment which was sent to Ukraine, it's now spreading all over the Muslim countries. How do you feel about that?
I don't think it's right, and I think Biden needs some accountability to be held to it.
Don't you feel like Biden is getting some piece of it, maybe 10% for the big guy?
I'm sorry, I didn't...
Don't you think Biden is getting some slack of it, maybe 10% for the big guy?
Well, that's right, yeah. There's no accountability there, and the whole thing should be open and above board, whatever he's doing, and it's not. They hide it all from
him. Awesome. How do you feel about Zelensky, who was sending billions of dollars, destroying Christian Orthodox churches one after another? Just one church was destroyed last weekend. So they completely demolished 1,000-year-old Christian Orthodox church because he's a Jew. How you feel about that?
I don't have a problem with him being a Jew.
How about the destroying Christian churches?
I'm sorry?
He was destroying Christian churches. He's destroying Christian churches in Ukraine.
They are, and they shouldn't be doing that. I mean, we're supporting some of the wrong people.
So how is democracy if there is no freedom of religion, and they also prohibit in Russian language?
I agree with you.
It's like if we decided to prohibit Mexican language or English language here. We say, well, so many Mexicans here, let's prohibit English completely. How you will feel about that?
Well, no accountability again. We got all these people coming in. There's no account to where they're going or what they're doing.
Awesome.
And half of them were going to, one of the kids are going to our schools and they can't even speak English. It's not right.
Yeah. Well, thank you for your opinion very much, because I want to tell people in Russia what's really going on and what real Americans think and what real patriots think, because they're showing us, you know, all the LGBTQ community in the United States, all the satanic rituals, and they presented it like all Americans like that. So I want to tell there are patriots, there are conservative values, people who don't care about the LGBT and don't support Biden administration. And I want to show how many people come to support President Trump. Thank you for your opinion again, guys. Ну, эти, конечно, ответили, что они вообще не поддерживают Зеленского никаким путем. И они требуют аудит. Мы хотим, чтобы был аудит, чтобы люди показывали, куда уходят деньги. Им тоже не нравится, что ветераны спят на полу, на улицах. И что, он говорит, должна быть accountability, то есть должна быть какой-то аудит, где люди должны знать, куда эти деньги посылаются. пойду еще раз пройдусь, пусть посмотрят на мою футболку российскую. Если кто-то внимание обратит, то я поговорю с ними. Но пока что меня еще никто не выгнал, это плюс большой. Так, сидеть возле сцены будет невозможно, но я смогу подойти поближе к сцене, когда начнется выступление Трампа, и спрошу, что они думают по этому поводу. Хочу увидеть, если кого-то из своих конгрессменов встречу, каких-нибудь знакомых, или, может, из русскоязычной комьюнити кого-нибудь увижу. Пока никого не вижу знакомых вообще. Я думала, будет, может быть, наш Тед Круз, сенатор. Так, давайте сейчас спрошу. Hello, so can I ask you a couple questions for... Are you not answering questions? You're not answering questions. You're afraid to be on ATV or on YouTube? Uh-huh, so this guy's a pussy, they don't want to answer any questions. Ну, не знаю, сейчас загребут еще меня с этим телефоном. Смотрят на меня, как на врага, понятно? То есть некоторые не захотели вообще отвечать, боятся. Реально просто боятся. Кто такой сидит на первом ряду и боится даже ответить на вопрос. Вот тут целая группа этих патриотов смотрят на меня, реально как будто бы вот готовы кинуться некоторые. Ну... Полный писец, знаете, прямо некоторые прямо кидаются на меня из-за Украины. Мы должны помочь украинцам бороться от этого страшного Путина, который нападает на нас, на всех. Мы должны помочь Украине, потому что на Украине демократия. Представляете, вот какие мозги, брейнвашт, это полностью промытые мозги у людей. Вот, и они, значит, говорят, мы должны помочь Украине бороться. Один единственный сказал, что я... за то, чтобы деньги не посылали, а оружие надо посылать, помогать Украине. Я говорю, ну так оружие... А, за оружием надо следить. Надо следить, куда это оружие пойдет, чтобы это оружие не попало в плохие руки. Я говорю, так уже все оружие украинское продается Талибану, продается там разным мусульманским странам. Как вы думаете насчет этого? Он такой, о, ну да, я про это не думал, но это ужасно, нам это не надо. Вот сидят ковбои, да, вот мы такие консервативные, мы такие протрамповские, в то же время сидят и поддерживают деньги на Украину. Я просто в шоке. Но большинство сказало, конечно, что они против. Но знаете, как против? Давайте оружие посылать, а деньги не посылать. Или давайте посылать, но делать аудит. Один прямо конкретно сказал... Путин тиран, мы должны остановить Путина, и мы должны посылать и деньги, и посылать оружие. И буквально вот прямо ненавистью на меня пыхал, что очень печально, ребята. Я, конечно, ожидала более продвинутых людей. Ага. Yeah, sure.